Hey folks, today I'm going to teach you how to create an audio journal. This is perfect for parents or grandparents who want to share stories from their life with future generations. And best of all, you won't need any third-party software for this, only what comes with your iPhone, iPad, or Mac. How to create an audio journal. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, and welcome to the class. I recently worked with a gentleman in his 80s who wanted to create a video for his granddaughter so he could share stories from his life. After we talked for a bit, I suggested that instead of making this a video project, it might be a better idea to go the path of least resistance and turn this into an audio-only project. The two best things about audio-only are it's easy to record at a moment's notice and it barely takes up any space on your devices. So here's how this tutorial works. I'm going to start by teaching you how to record and organize this information, then I'll teach you how to make minor edits, and finally I'll teach you what you need to do to ensure that this information can be protected and easily passed down to your loved ones upon your death. The first thing I want you to do is to go into your iPhone or iPad, go into Settings, and then scroll down to Voice Memos. From here, I want you to tap on where it says audio quality. I recommend that you change it to lossless audio quality because there's nothing worse than bad audio. Now, I'm sure you probably want to know, well, how much extra space will this take up? And the answer is, it's really not that bad. For example, 5 hours of recordings will take up approximately 420 megabytes. The compressed version would be right around 270. So please, take my advice and switch this setting over to lossless. The future thanks you. At this point, let's go into the Voice Memos app, and if your screen looks something like this, I want you to tap on the back arrow here at the top left. The first thing I want you to do is to create a basic folder structure. There's a couple of different ways that you can do this. For example, you could do it by decades. So you could start with childhood and then move on to your teens, your 20s, your 30s, or you could do it by topic. So for example, it could be a folder of life lessons learned, another for stories about places that you traveled to, and another for why your uncle doesn't appear as your uncle on ancestry.com. What happened there, Mom? Once you've created this folder structure, I encourage you to go into the Files app and create the exact same folder structure inside of iCloud Drive. Here under Locations, I'm going to tap on iCloud Drive. Now I'll tap on the three dots icon at the top right and create a new folder. And for this, I'm going to call it Audio Journal. And now inside of that, I'm going to create another folder structure, which is the same one we just created a second ago. So one for childhood, one for teens, one for 20s, yada, yada, yada. At this point, we're ready to record, so let's switch back to the Voice Memos app, and let's say I want to create a story that is going to ultimately live inside of the childhood folder. Just tap the big red button and start a-talking. When you're done, tap the red stop button to end the recording. Now let's go over some editing basics. Let's say there's something in there that I want to correct. Just tap the three dots icon followed by Edit Recording. Now you can scroll to that moment, tap replace, and say whatever you want to replace it with. I now want to teach you two other types of edits, how to delete segments of a voice memo and how to trim. Let's say I start the recording and it takes me a couple of minutes to just get my thoughts collected. From the edit screen, we're going to tap on the crop symbol here at the top right. Then here at the bottom, I can take the left pointing arrow and drag it a little bit to the right. Now just tap trim. If there's a segment in the middle of the recording that you need to edit out, just drag the left pointing arrow to the beginning of that segment that needs to be cut out, then drag the right pointing arrow to just before where you want it to resume. Now tap delete. Now let's say you tap delete when you realize you meant to tap trim or vice versa. Step one, don't panic. All you need to do to undo an action on your iPhone or iPad is give it a little shake back and forth. If you're doing this on a Mac, the keyboard shortcut for undo is Command Z. At this point, let's move our files into iCloud Drive. For starters, let's tap on the edit button here at the top right. And now we're going to select all the files that we want to move. Then we're going to tap on the share button at the bottom left and scroll up on this window. Now I realize you're going to be tempted to tap on where it says move to folder, but that's not what you think. That's to move it to another folder inside of the Voice Memos app. So what I want you to do is to save it to files. Now, all you need to do is point it to the folder that we created inside of iCloud Drive and then tap Save at the top right. Now, if you're doing this on a Mac, for some strange, weird reason, Apple doesn't allow you to select multiple voice memos and move them all at once. So you're gonna ultimately need to drag and drop them one by one from the Voice Memos app into your desired folder, hopefully that lives inside of iCloud Drive. The last thing that we need to do is to protect this folder so that it is passed down to your loved ones upon your death. The easiest way to set this up is from your iPhone. Once again, I want you to go into Settings and tap on your name at the top. Now, I want you to tap on where it says Password and Security. Now, I want you to scroll down to the bottom of this list and tap on where it says Legacy Contact. You'll now need to tap on where it says Add Legacy Contact, and now you need to navigate to that person's contact card. You should know that you can have multiple legacy contacts, but you can only add them one at a time. When you get to your loved one's contact card, you will need to tap on their phone number, and from there, there are two ways that you can send authorization. One method is you can send it over a text message. The other option is you can print out a code. I almost always recommend sending authorization via a text message. However, if the person you want to designate as a legacy contact is an Android user, the only option will be to print out a code that you will have to physically give to them. When that day inevitably comes, your loved ones will need to be able to provide a death certificate. Then they just need to visit digital-legacy.apple.com. And after Apple verifies everything, your loved ones will have access to any data that is stored inside of iCloud Drive for 3 years. There are a few exceptions, like for example, passwords, licensed media like movies, TV shows, books, and songs, your email, or payment information. Keep in mind, if you would ever like to work with me one-on-one or with your spouse from the comfort of your own home, you can book a 1-hour tech therapy session with me on my website at techtalkamerica.com. Don't forget to hit the like button, and if you haven't already done so, please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.